Torque of DC motor is a very important parameter. To establish the torque equation, let us first consider the basic circuit diagram of a DC motor and its voltage equation. So here we have a DC motor. And here the brushes. And here we have the resistance of the armature or the rotor of the DC motor. And connected to a DC power supply. So here we have VA minus plus. We have RA and the current flowing through the winding is IA. And here we will get back EMF and we will call it EB. And also the DC motor is connected to a load through a shaft. Here we have the coupler. And this is the shaft. And we can say here the load. So this is the shaft. And these are brushes. So we can say here VA is the supply voltage. RA armature system, IA armature current EB back EMF. So by applying Kirchhoff voltage law, we will have VA equals EB plus IA RA. Our goal is to derive the torque equation of DC motor. So let's multiply both sides by IA. So here we will have VA IA equals EB IA plus IA square RA. This term represents the power loss due to heating of the armature coil. So this is power loss in armature winding. And this term represents the true effective mechanical power that is required to produce the desired torque of DC machine. So we will call it here mechanical power. Mechanical power. So here the mechanical power will equal to EBIA. And we can relate this power to the electromagnetic torque by using this equation, Pm equals torque multiplied by omega, because this shaft will rotate by omega. Now let's equate these two equations. EBIA will equal T omega. And we know also that back EMF EB equals P phi Z N. We will describe these parameters divided by 60 A. So B is number of pole and phi is flux per pole. Which is also called a flux density. Z is a number of conductors, and N is speed of DC motor. In RPM, revolution per minute, and A is number of parallel paths. Also, to get omega, here omega is rad or radian per second, and N is revolution per minute. So how to relate both variables? To get omega, for example, we have N, so here omega will equal what? N, the unit is revolution per minute. So to get rid of minute, we have to multiply by 1 minute divided by 60 seconds. So this is 1 multiplied by 1. And to get rid of revolution, we know that from circle, we have circle here. Here 0 by over 2 by 3 by over 2 and 2 by, which represent 360 degrees. And this also will equal 1 revolution. So 1 revolution, because here is on the numerator, so we have to put it here on the denominator. So 1 revolution will equal 2 pi. So R with R will go, and minute with minute will go. So we can say here that omega will equal 2 by N divided by 60. And if we have omega and we want the speed in RPM, so we can say also N equals 60 omega divided by 2 by. So now we can substitute this EB here and also omega, this one here. We can do it here. By taking this one and this one and also this one. We can say that P phi Z N over 60 A IA because these represent back EMF, EB, equal T omega. T is here, and omega for this one, omega is 2 by N over 60. 2 by N over 60. So this represents omega. What we can do? We can take N with N. Also, we can take 60 with 60. At the end, we can say that torque will equal PZ phi IA over 2 by A. The torque we so obtain is known as the electromagnetic torque of DC motor. And subtracting the mechanical and rotational losses from it, we get the mechanical torque. Therefore, the mechanical torque, Tm, will equal T minus mechanical losses. This is the torque equation of DC motor. It can be further simplified as follows. T equals K phi I A, because these are constant. Equal K. So this K is constant for a particular machine, and therefore the torque of DC motor varies with only flux and armature current. So this is one of the most important equations used in DC motors. And in some references, they use this alternative equations, T equals D IF I A. IF is field current, and D is also a constant. Why? Because phi, the flux density, is proportional to IF. And we will see this one in DC motors. The other most important equation is EB, when it is represented as a function of flux and omega. So how to find it? We know that EB equals P phi Z N over 60 A. And we know that omega equals 2 by N over 60. So this one will equals what? B phi Z. Let's make it like this. Divided by 60 here. And let's put A here. And also, we will put here 2 by, and we can cancel this 2 by here. So nothing new. So we put 2 by, and we cancel it also. And we will put N. This term will represent omega. So EB will equal BZ over 2 by A multiplied by phi multiplied by omega. And don't forget that this term equal to K, which is a constant. So the back EMF EB equals K phi omega, and it is so important equation. And also in some references they use it EB equals DIF omega. So these equations will be seen later in our DC motor modules. Thank you so much, and I will see you in the next video.